mission of the Boy Scouts of America is to prepare young people to make ethical and moral choices over their lifetimes by instilling in them the values of the Scout Oath and law.
On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times, keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
Trustworthy.
Helpful. Friendly. Courteous. Kind. Obedient. Cheerful. Thrifty. Brave. Clean. And reverent.
The Scouting program has three specific objectives, commonly referred to as the aims of Scouting. They are growth of moral strength and character, participating citizenship, and development of physical, mental, and emotional fitness.
Boy Scouting uses 8 specific methods to achieve these aims.
The ideals of Boy Scouting are spelled out in the Scout Oath, the Scout Law, the Scout Motto, and the Scout Slogan. Boy Scout measures himself against these ideals and continually tries to improve.
The patrol method gives Boy Scouts an experience in group living and participating citizenship. It places responsibility on young shoulders and teaches boys how to accept it. The patrol method allows Scouts to interact in small groups where they can easily relate to each other. These small groups determine troop activities through their elected representatives.
Boy Scouting is designed to take place outdoors. It is in the outdoor setting that Scouts share responsibilities and learn to live with one another. It is here that skills and activities practiced at troop meetings come alive with purpose. Being close to nature helps Boy Scouts gain an appreciation for God's handiwork and humankind's place in it. The outdoors is the laboratory for Boy Scouts to learn ecology and practice conservation of nature's resources.
Boy Scouting provides a series of surmountable obstacles and steps in overcoming them through the advancement method. The Boy Scouts plan his advancement and progresses at his own pace as he meets each challenge. The Boy Scout is rewarded for each achievement, which helps him gain self-confidence. The steps in the advancement system help a Boy Scout grow in self-reliance and the ability to help others.
Boys learn a great deal by watching how adults conduct themselves. Scout leaders can be positive role models for the members of their troops. In many cases, a scoutmaster who is willing to listen to boys, encourage them, and take a sincere interest in them can make a profound difference in their lives.
As Boy Scouts plan their activities and progress toward their goals, they experience personal growth. The good turn concept is a major part of the personal growth method of Boy Scouting. Boys grow as they participate in the community service projects and do good turns for others. Possibly no device is so successful in developing a basis for personal growth as the daily good turn. The religious emblems program also is a large part of the personal growth method. Frequent personal conferences with his scoutmaster help each Boy Scout to determine his growth towards scouting's aims.
The Boy Scout program encourages boys to learn and practice leadership skills. Every Boy Scout has the opportunity to participate in both shared and total leadership situations. Understanding the concepts of leadership helps a boy accept the leadership role of others and guides him towards the citizenship aim of scouting.
The uniform makes the Boy Scout troop visible as a force for good and creates a positive youth image in the community. Boy Scouting is an action program, and wearing the uniform is an action that shows each Boy Scout's commitment to the aims and purposes of scouting.
The uniform gives the Boy Scout identity in a world brotherhood of youth who believe in the same ideals. The uniform is practical attire for Boy Scout activities and provides a way for Boy Scouts to wear the badges that show what they have accomplished.
With these 8 methods, Scouting builds character, develops citizenship, and promotes fitness.
Of any 100 boys who become Scouts, 30 will drop out in their first year. But in later life, all of these will remember that they had been Scouts and will speak well of the program. Of the 100, only rarely will one ever appear before a juvenile court judge.
12 of the 100 will be from families that belong to no church. Through scouting, these 12 and many of their families will be brought into contact with a church and will continue to be active all of their lives. 6 of the 100 will become pastors.
Each of the 100 will learn something from scouting. Almost all will develop hobbies that will add interest throughout the rest of their lives. Approximately half will serve in the military and in varying degrees profit from their scout training.
At least one will use his scout training to save another person's life, and many will credit it with saving their own. 4 of the 100 will reach Eagle rank, and at least one will later say that he valued his Eagle above his college degree.
Many will find their future vocation through merit badge work and scouting contacts. 17 of the 100 boys will later become scout leaders and will give leadership to thousands of additional boys.
Only 1 in 4 boys in America will become a scout. But it is interesting to know that of the leaders in this nation in business, religion, and politics, 3 out of 4 were scouts.
In U.S. high schools, 85% of student council presidents were scouts.
89% of senior class presidents were scouts.
80% of junior class presidents were scouts.
75% of school publication editors were scouts.
71% of football captains were scouts.
Scouts account for 64% of Air Force Academy graduates.
68% of West Point graduates.
70% of Annapolis graduates.
72% of Rhodes Scholars.
85% of FBI agents.
And 26 of the first 29 astronauts.
For over 50 years, Troop 45 has proudly added to this legacy in Warwick, and we hope your family will join us.
Have I done and have I dared everything?